Channel. So this video has been so highly requested, and it's something that I have taken a while to kind of figure out what works for me, what doesn't, and it's taken 4 years of experience in the YouTube realm to really nail this down. So that's why I haven't done this video sooner. And this video is what I shoot, edit, and film with. So I'm going to be going over all of the cameras that I use, the lenses, the video cameras, what I edit with, and things like that. So if you're interested in watching this and hearing all of that, stay tuned. Okay, to start this off, I am by no means a professional videographer, photographer, anything like that, not a professional editor, but I have been doing YouTube and Instagram for a little over 4 years, and over those 4 years, I've found what works for me and what doesn't. I've learned more, and the more you learn and the more you do, there's more equipment to buy, and it just gets a little crazy. So I've kind of narrowed it down now to what I love to use, and I have a few different things for different things that I do. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about is the cameras that I use. The first one that I have here is a Canon body, and this is an EOS 80D, and we have actually had this for like 2 years now, so it's kind of outdated. We have different lenses that we'll switch out and use with it, but we did just order a new Canon body, and that one's coming this week actually. And that is a Canon mirrorless, and it's an EOS R. So that's the new body we have coming. So we will now have two Canon bodies. And this one I'll probably like take on trips with me since it's a little older now. And then that new one is what we're going to be using for all of our photo shoots moving forward. And then the lens that I have on this one currently, this is a Canon lens, and it's a 16-35mm. So it can zoom in and out, and it can go all different lengths, which is really nice. And we actually ordered two new lenses to go with the new body that we ordered as well. This one is a 50mm lens, so that's a really good one for close-up shots. And then we also ordered another lens, and we basically just ordered another Canon 16-35mm that's a little more updated than this one. And now we have two since we do have two bodies. And that lens is honestly my go-to because I can zoom in really close and zoom out. If your lens doesn't have a range, then it usually just stays in one spot. So like the 50mm, it won't zoom in and out. And for video and some photos we take, we like to get a lot of detail shots. So that's why this lens is good to have, but it's also good to have options, which is why we have the other one as well. I also have a few other lenses as well, and I have another camera I'm going to be talking about, and these lenses go with that camera and this one and the new one. So they're all Canon, which is nice because it keeps it in the family. We also have some Sigma lenses that I've really liked as well because they fit these bodies too. All right, and another lens we have is the 50-250mm lens, so it has quite a range. We use this one quite often, and then I also have an 18-55mm lens. So we just kind of have a range between all of the lenses that we have. These ones are smaller, and then this one's a little bit bigger, and then this one is a lot bigger. So this is the Sigma lens I was talking about, and this one is an 85mm, so it just stays at one spot. It doesn't zoom in or out. I don't love that when I'm doing like videos especially, because I need to be able to get closer detailed shots and then also zoom out for like the intro and things like that. But this is really good if you are doing something close up. So when I'm doing like a tutorial that is close up most of the time, this is great. Or if you want detailed shots of something that you're taking a photo of. And then we also have this attachment that kind of goes on here, and we have a lot of fun things like this that have just come with the things we bought. And honestly, I don't know enough about this to really like give you guys advice on if you need this or what kind of lighting or what kind of attachments you need. But my sister and I are going to be taking a photography class soon to learn about the equipment we have and what we can do to better it. So I will do an updated video once I have a little more experience in all of the new things that we've gotten that have been working really well for us. All right, time for this monster. So this is a really big camera. I got this specifically for video shooting. This is a great camera for both. You can take photos and shoot video, but it's mainly used for videographers to get those really amazing videos. And this is a Canon Mark II, I believe it's called. It's an EOS 1D. So if you're a photographer, you definitely know what that means. I really don't know the difference between all these. I just know that these are the things we've been advised to buy. So the Canon is great, like I said. This is a 24 to 105 millimeter lens on here. This has a really good range as well. So this is another one of my favorite lenses to use. And then it has a really big back like here. So you can see that there's a big screen. And honestly, this camera is a monster. Like I said, the battery is huge and the memory card's big. So it requires all of its own things like memory card reader, batteries, stuff like that. And this has been really great for having in the studio for filming videos. So I've been shooting pretty much all my YouTube videos on this camera. And we don't like to take this one out. So with this one, for example, if we're needing to do a shoot out on location, we'll take this one. And our new one that's coming is used for that as well. But if I'm shooting a video, I'm using this in studio only. And then I have another camera that I will take if I need to vlog or be on the go doing video outside the studio. And that camera is actually the one I'm filming on right now, so I will insert some clips of it so you guys can see what it looks like. This is my vlogging camera, and honestly, you guys, I've had like four different vlogging cameras over the last couple of years, and this is by far my favorite one. It's a Sony, and my husband actually helped me pick this one out, so shout out to Jordan because he does his research. He lets me know what I need to buy, what's the best, and this one is by far the best vlogging camera I've ever had. It has amazing features. It has a built-in microphone, a built-in lens cover. It comes with a microphone like fuzzy attachment so you can film in the wind without hearing any background noise. It has a flip out screen, which is always really helpful with vlogging. And then it also has a tripod that I bought with it, which I will link the kit I got below because I got everything. You don't need to buy the tripod, but this tripod is incredible. It stabilizes things. It holds itself up really well. It's sturdy. And then it also has buttons on it, and you can attach your camera to the tripod, and you can literally like just press the record button and your whole camera will turn on and start recording. So you don't have to open it and turn it on yourself. It's awesome. So if you are looking into getting a vlogging camera that is really good quality and you want to be, you know, easy on the go, it's really small and lightweight and it's amazing. This is your camera. I love it. It also takes really good photos as well, so it can be used for both, but it's really a great video camera. So this is what I use to film on the go, and it's been amazing. Jordan has the exact same ones. We have like matching vlog cameras because now that we are doing our family channel, we are both needing to have cameras, and these have been great. So those are the things that I use for my YouTube videos, vlogging, things like that, professional photo shoots. When it comes to Instagram, I sometimes use a professional camera to shoot my photos, but I would say 99% of the time I'm just using my iPhone. I have the iPhone 12 Pro Max, so I do have the newest one, and I always like to get the newest iPhone there is, the one with the best camera, because they're always updating the cameras and the cameras always have really great features, and I just like to stay up to date with that because if I ever need to vlog on my phone or take photos on my phone in a pinch, I like to have the best quality. And honestly, your phone is really great for so many things. Hair photos, outfit photos, anything you can do. I even vlog on it sometimes, like I said, and it works really well. I would say the only downside with vlogging on your phone is you don't have a microphone, whereas with these types of cameras, you usually do. If I am doing audio on my big camera, I do just have a plug-in microphone. It's a Rode mic, and it just attaches right in here and plugs into your camera, and that's the best audio for this. And then the one I'm filming on now has the built-in microphone, which is really convenient and nice for vlogging cameras. And then I, of course, have lens covers for all my lenses. That's really important. You never want to lose those. I have extras. I've bought in like a ton on Amazon just in case. And then the nice thing about this little vlogging camera I have is, like I said, it's a built-in lens cover. So as soon as the lens goes back inside, it shuts over itself. So you never have to worry about losing your lens on the go. All right, I wanted to show you guys this as well because this has been so helpful. So I basically keep all of my camera equipment and stuff like this over here in my office, and having all of my chargers plugged in and ready to go at all times has been a game changer. So this is our Canon charger. These are my vlogging chargers. So I literally have four batteries for my vlog camera charging at all times. This is a powered brick, so it can charge my laptop, my phone, everything like that on the go. these are the batteries for that big monster camera. So we have two charging at all time. And then we obviously have this little guy so that everything can charge at once. And then I also have my Bluetooth headphones charging. And if you are someone that's gonna be using equipment like this all the time, I would definitely recommend setting something like this up and having your chargers just immediately charging at all times. Because if you end up losing battery in the middle of a video, this is really helpful so that you don't have to get a new battery out, wait for it to charge. For example, in the middle of filming this video, my camera died, so I just switched it out. I'm charging the old battery, and then I have these ones all ready to go. So that's really convenient. And then I also have backup batteries for all of the cameras that we take on the go. So the Canon and these, because this is my vlogging camera, I have them all separately in a bag that I take. So I have all these camera bags over here. These ones are my favorite. They're so cute. And we just keep the chargers in there so that when we're taking the cameras on the go, there's always chargers in there and we never run into any problems. I also have a bunch of extra memory cards, lens covers, like I told you guys, chargers, and it's really important to always just have extras of these. And in our to-go bags, we always have extra memory cards as well so that we never run into full memory or a dead battery. Okay, I'm gonna touch on the podcast equipment as well, even though this isn't like filming and editing. This is kind of important too because it has to go along with audio and content. So it's been really hard to find good podcast equipment. And I'll be honest, the biggest thing I've struggled with being on YouTube and creating content is audio. Making sure that your videos sound good, they're not fuzzy, they're not too quiet, not too loud. And even now as I'm filming this, I'm in my studio. And if you guys hear that annoying little beeping that comes and goes every couple minutes, things like that drive me crazy in videos. And unfortunately, that's the alarm system in here. So I've been talking with the audio guys on how to get rid of that, but there's always things like that that come up, and especially when doing a podcast, it can be really hard. But we did get these headphones, and they come with the headphone holders, which is really nice. We have these microphones, and they each have their own stand, and then we are connected to this box, and it connects to our headphones and our microphones, and then it all connects into my computer with this. And then we also have these pop filters. So we have our microphone usually on its stand in front of this. And this just helps block out any noise and it gets rid of like the popping sounds when you do your pees and things like that. So this has by far been the best podcast equipment we've had yet. It's been an adventure. There's been a lot of come and go. We've had new equipment and this has been the best. So I will link all of this below as well. Okay, so now we are at my computer. This is where I do all of my editing. I do have a laptop as well that I use when I'm on trips or on the go, but honestly, I do prefer to edit on a desktop because it's just a lot bigger and a lot more convenient, but it is good to have both. And then I do have this hard drive that has everything on it so I can switch it back and forth between my laptop and computer. So it's basically like having the same thing no matter what one I'm on. So when it comes to voiceovers and sometimes podcasts as well, I will use this. This is a mic we got on Amazon and it came with an attachment like this. It also has a filter right here so that everything sounds a little bit better. So this is connected to my computer right now. So when I do all of my voiceovers, I just lean over and do it right here, which is really convenient. And then to edit, I use Final Cut Pro. I'm sure if you are an editor or you do any type of video editing at all, you use Final Cut Pro. This has been amazing. I just finished this video right here. I edit my IGTV videos on this, my vlogs, my YouTube videos, all of it. And I really like it because it is a little more complex than iMovie. I started off on iMovie and that's really great for beginners, but Final Cut Pro is just amazing and it does take a little time to learn. I did go through a bunch of YouTube tutorials to learn everything and it took me a while, but I've been using it about 2 or 3 years now and it's been awesome. So it's really nice because you can do music, sound effects, you can do titles and generators, you can come over here and do transitions, you can add different sound effects and you can do video filters. I did buy a bunch of video presets that I will use and you can kind of customize your channel even more the more you learn this and add things like that. So Final Cut Pro is kind of expensive. It's just a one-time buy. I think of $300, but it's so worth it. It's what I use for everything and I am obsessed. To do our podcast, I use Audacity. This is how we film the podcast. So basically you just start recording right here and then you export the file and then I actually edit that in Final Cut Pro as well. Something that has saved my life being an editor, I guess. I'm not even an editor, but since I do that pretty much every day now, having the hard drive. So for example, I pull it up And this is just always plugged into my Mac, but I can put it in my laptop as well, like I said. And I have everything categorized right here. So I have a YouTube folder with my intros, all my banners, my graphics. The Naughty Family channel has its own folder. Education with Jessie has a folder. So this keeps me really organized. I also have a folder for music. So all the music I use on my YouTube videos, I always have things to choose from. I use Epidemic Sound. I have a membership with them, and you can always get new audio and music and sound effects from them. So the ones that I get, I end up saving in this folder. And then I have a video presets folder. So if I ever lose anything, it's all here. So that's also amazing to have, just because it's going to keep you very organized as you're editing. Okay, guys, I also wanted to show you a little bit about how I edit on my phone. So on my phone, I have a folder called editing. So I'm just going to open that up right here, and you can see that I have a bunch of different apps. The Tezza app is great because this can edit photos and videos. So it's really good for Instagram stories or IGTVs, and then just daily photos you're posting. Lightroom is another favorite I have for filming. Lightroom is another favorite I have for editing my photos. I feel like Lightroom is a little more professional. You can change a lot more. It's not just slapping a filter on, so that's really good for custom things. Mojo is another app I use. This is really great for stories that you want to be really interactive. They're video stories, they move, and they have a lot of different features on them. InShot is an app I use to edit my videos on my phone. So for IGTV, that's really helpful. Sometimes stories, things like that. So when I'm not with my computer, I edit on InShot. Facetune is also great. You can smooth things, you can whiten backgrounds, you can brighten things, you can patch and hide things. So Facetune is just something I think that everyone needs. YouCam makeup is if you need to like touch up makeup on someone in a photo. I use this a lot for my clients. If I take a photo of them and they're like, oh, I didn't wear makeup, you can just kind of make them look a little more refreshed and put together, which is always nice. Storylux is really great for creating stories and putting photos together. Canva is what I use to do my YouTube thumbnails, my YouTube channel art. It has a lot of good templates for stories as well. So that's just really good for social media in general. Split pick is putting two pictures together side by side, and I love this one because it blurs the center so it looks really seamless. Canva Stories is just another version of Canva meant for stories. And then I have iMovie on here, which I don't use a ton. Video Splitter, I don't use a ton, but if I have a long video I need to break up, I'll use that. And then Retouch is good to remove objects from the background of your photos. So those are my main video editing and photo editing apps, but I would say I mostly use the ones in this first page. This is the tripod I like to use for my cameras. This is really helpful, especially when doing YouTube videos. It has a little guy right here that you hold onto, and you can move it up and down or sideways, back and forth. And it's really secure and stable, and you can lower it and raise it. This is also the light I like to use. Ring lights are great, but I feel like sometimes they're not amazing, especially when it gets darker outside. So we have these shadow box, I think they're called, lights. And I have a bunch of these from Amazon, and those are super helpful. And then this tripod is one that I got on Amazon as well, and this one's for your phone. I use this all the time for IGTVs. It's so convenient to have this for your phone. I love this thing, and I use it every single day. So if you don't have a camera and you're doing a lot on your phone, this is gonna be your best friend. Another thing I have that's been really useful is we recently got this backdrop, and as you can see, it's just a piece of paper, and we have different colors of papers, and it's held up like this. So when we're shooting things, this is super helpful because we can have different colors of backdrops. And I also have three different colors of wall back here, so I have different backdrops for photos and videos. All right, you guys, that was it for today's video. I hope that you learned a little something. Let me know if you would like more videos like this in the future. Have a great day. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.